Good evening, church family. Have you received a blessing in the Lord's house today? I hope you have. Are you glad to be here? Good. I'm glad you're here too. Or else I'd be preaching to my wife and son. Amen. I'll leave that alone, Richard. Take your Bibles to Matthew chapter 19 tonight. We're going to look at some familiar scriptures here this evening. We're going to do something just a little different, deviate from our series in James. Being that it is Bible school, the Lord really just laid this on my heart here, really over the last, I'd say, 3-4 days. And just thought it'd be a good challenge for us tonight, things to remember as we look at Bible school. And it is really a joy of mine to be part of this. As Pastor said, I am in charge of planning and preparing. Here, I think, 10 years ago when we came, before we were on staff, Mrs. Taylor let the reins go on the Bible school and showed me all the ins and outs of how you folks did it here. And we had done it at our previous church for years before. And but I want to say, having said that, this cannot be done without you. This is nothing to do with me. This is all you folks here. So I thank you so much even for your help as of just recent, getting some things set up and getting some things prepared. Lots and lots go into this. And we'll even have a little bit of time to set up afterwards. So if you're able to help with that, I would encourage you to stay. It won't take us too long, maybe half an hour if that, get things ready for tomorrow. But we do thank you ahead of time. And then be praying, as we will here tonight, before we close, really wrapped around the theme of our message here tonight. As Pastor said, be praying for this week. As you have heard, lots of preparation goes into this. But now we leave it into the Spirit's hand, and we are hoping that these boys and girls learn of Christ, and those that need to know him as their Savior make that decision this week, and those that know him are grown deeper and deeper in their faith as they're taught many of these Bible lessons, these Bible stories, and just the great time we have together through this week. But tonight, really, I want to talk about just a simple subject, and we will not be long tonight, just a push for tomorrow. Why do we have Vacation Bible School? Why have it? See, nowhere in the Bible do we say, you know, Community Baptist Church must have Vacation Bible School from Monday to Thursday or Monday to Friday or anything like that. So why have it? Obviously, it's a tradition that many of us churches have partaken part of through the many years. But by the time we're done tonight, I want to give you some just practical reasons as to why we do have it and why it's important, along with really all of our other children's ministries. And I think really, as I said here just a few days ago, I've really just been burdened in regards to these young people that will be here this week and really desiring to see the Lord move this year in our Bible school program as well. So to get us started, just some illustrations, if you would, about Bible school and some students. A Bible school teacher asked her student, do you believe that story about Lot's wife looking back and turning into a pillar of salt? One little boy said, sure I do. Just yesterday, my mother looked back and turned into a telephone pole. I like that. I like that. A mother asked her son, what did you learn today in VBS? The son said, and he had his words mixed up, but the son said that God created the world in 11 days. Mother said, but that's not true, son. God created the world in 7 days. The son said, in that case, I didn't learn anything. That's Lance. That's my son right there. That's exactly. Slackers, I'm telling you. Then the last one. The youngster went home after VBS, I like this, said to his father, he was all excited, today we heard a wonderful story from the Bible. The teacher said the Jews were chased out of Egypt by Egyptian tanks. When they came to the Red Sea, the Jews saw the Egyptian tanks coming after them, so they built a bridge and went over safely. But when the Egyptians kept coming, they blew it up with an atomic bomb, and the Egyptians were destroyed. The joke's not even done, brother. You got to wait till we get to the end, man. His father said, "Did the teacher really tell you the story that way?" He replied, "No, Dad, but if I told you how he did tell it, you'd never believe me." Mr. Riley's contemplating that one. See? Why have Bible school? As I said, look at Matthew chapter 19. You know this scripture well. You've heard it read several times. Matthew chapter 19, verse 13. "Then were they brought unto him," this was brought unto Christ, "little children, that should put his hands on them and pray, and his disciples rebuked them." In other words, these children, just Christ is too much to do right now, right? That's really the thought of the disciples. He's just too busy. But Jesus said, "Suffer, little children, and forbid them not to come unto me, for of such is the kingdom of heaven." He laid his hands on them and departed thence. We see Christ even here understanding and really teaching us the importance of ministering to our young people. And it should be a joy. Should be something you love to do. Should be something you have a burden for. Even if you don't teach, if you're here tonight, maybe you're not even going to be part of Bible school this year. You know what? You can pray. By the time we're done tonight, you can go home with a bit of a burden for what's going to take place here this week, to see what God's going to do in the lives of these young people through you, through all of us. Isn't that neat? Through Community Baptist Church. Whether you're here Monday through Thursday, or whether you're home praying, whether you're thinking about us, or you supported us with cookies or candy, or whatever your part was, you have a special place in this year's Bible school. We all should share that burden together. We don't do it just to fill a week. Trust me, summer weeks get full. So we don't do it just to fill a calendar. Say, bless God, we're going to have Bible school. We've had it for 50 years, and we're going to have it for another 50. Well, we are, but that's not why we do it. It's not just a place on the calendar. It's not just to have another ministry activity. And just quickly tonight, why have it? A couple of things, right? First and foremost, kids love it. Kids have a great time. They love Bible school. You come and you're invited to come tomorrow through Thursday. Just come and sit. Come during our opening. Opening's usually, you know, the first 20 minutes or so, and closing program is the same. So you want to really see some kids excited, show up at 6 o'clock, or you want to see some kids excited, show up about 8:15, 8:10, somewhere in there. You're going to see some kids that just love Bible school. It's a great outreach for us, and we're going to get to that point in a minute. But kids enjoy themselves. It's a time where they can come and, man, want to be in church, want to be here. And yes, we're going to get to number two here in a minute. We have Bible school because it's fun, but we're going to use that fun in a way to teach and instill in them the truth of God's word. So why have it? Because kids love it. And secondly, because it's fun. And that's okay. That's okay. We can have fun in church. We can gather and do things to have fun. We say, well, bless God, that ought not to be our main. No, you're right. It's not. But Bible school's fun. And let me tell you, you do a lot of things at home that maybe aren't so spiritual. They're not wrong, but you have fun. That's what we're doing. We're trying to create an environment where these kids want to come, and boy, they're excited, and they see these prizes, and they want to bring visitors, and they want to say their memory verses, and they want to just be obedient during class time and game time and all these things. They want to see Mr. Doro and Isaac Osman look all goofy during the skits and just have a great time together. It's fun. They want to see Pastor Taylor come on up here and do candy grab, and his wife irritate him half to death the whole time. That's what they do. She banters him and tells him jokes, and, you know, he blows her off, and they have that, you know, like they normally do, just during Bible school. I have to be careful now. He told me he can hear what I'm preaching now with new hearing aids. So when I start talking about him, remind me to lower my voice just a little bit. But we have fun. Man, those kids love seeing their number called and coming up here and reaching into a great big bin of candy, and how much they can get is what they get to have. They have a great time in all that we do, watching the Doros, Mr. Cagle lead music time, and just having a great time jumping around and singing songs, and it's fun. That's why we have it. The kids love it. It's fun. Now, on a spiritual aspect, it's a great outreach. It's a great outreach for our church. It's been proven through the years that it is a wonderful outreach for our church. And I will tell you this, it's no different than any other outreach that we have here at Community Baptist Church. Vacation Bible School is just as important as Community Day. Vacation Bible School is just as important as our Wild Game Dinner or Release Time Bible Class or any of these outreaches that we have. They're all just cohesively working together as we're desiring to train these young people up under the preaching of God's Word. And we're going to continue to have that outreach. We're going to continue to want to, as we said, have it because kids love it. We're going to continue to have it in a way that it is fun and enjoyable for them to come. But man, what a wonderful opportunity for our church. You know, we run fairly good attendance during Bible school. You know, we're in the 40s most days, and that's pretty good for a church our size. And there's a lot of visitors that come throughout a week. I think on average over the past 10 years, we would average from the start of the week to the end of the week, almost every week, we see almost, if not, right around 50 kids come through this church. So our average attendance is 35-40. But by the time you get kid number one registered on Monday to the last kid on Thursday or Friday, whenever you stood on Friday, that's about 50-some kids that come. Boy, that's a great outreach, isn't it? 50 young people together, having fun, hearing God's word, us being able to share with them the importance of learning God's word and taking part in memorizing it and committing it to memory and all of those things that we do with them that the teachers will do this week. Just a great time. It's an opportunity to share the gospel. That's why we have it. It's an opportunity to share the gospel. We want to see these boys and girls come to know Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. We absolutely want to have fun. Miss Jessie's in charge of game time, and she's going to boss Adam around the whole week. And you know what? They're going to have a great time out there. They're going to get the bounce houses out. They're going to play all kinds of games. And man, we're going to have a blast. We also want to have these young people hear the gospel. We also want, more than once throughout this week, have them have an opportunity to receive Christ as their Savior if they haven't already. It's an opportunity to share the gospel. Again, think about that number with 40, 50 kids. Say, well, I know a lot of those are church kids, and they are, but you know what? A lot of visitors. You know what also happens then as we share the gospel with these young people? You know what they do? A lot of times they take these papers home. You know what these papers have on them? The gospel. Every year we give them a little gift. Just one thing we give them is a little bookmark, the ABCs of salvation. They take those things home. You don't know what that's going to do in a family. You don't know how that's going to reach, who that's going to reach, whether it's mom or dad or brother or sister or anyone. It's an opportunity to reach many, many boys and girls, many, many family members that didn't even come just by looking at the materials we sent home, just by their youngsters going home and saying, I had such a great time today, and here's what I learned. This is what I learned, to their mom and dad. Every year, one of my really goals or challenge, if you would, is we prepare for Bible school, and when we have our workers meeting, I ask the workers to pray with me that through Bible school, I want to see at least one family member come and see our church. That's just a prayer I have. Throughout those 40, 50 kids that come through, I'm praying that we see one family member, whether it's mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, aunt, or uncle, I don't care, but I'd like to see one person come and visit our church. Now, hey, the Lord can provide a lot more, and maybe my faith is weak, but I'm praying for one. That's what I'd like to see God do. I'd like you to pray. Are you burdened for Bible school? Are you burdened for community day, our wild game dinner, our release time, our Sunday school classes, our junior church program, our CBC Kids during the school year, our CBC Kids during the summer? Let's get a burden. It's not just place the kids in the basement, know they're being taught well. Let's get a burden at Community Baptist Church. And you're going to see them come and go. You're going to see them have a great time. But let's see mom and dad. Let's see grandma and grandpa. Let's see an aunt and uncle. Let's see brother and sister. Pastor Jeremy and his wife done a great job this last month, really getting out there and, man, handing out some literature and flyers and door hangers. And we've seen kids already registered just by phone that have never came before. That's what we're about. That's what it's about. It's an opportunity to share the gospel. And with that, I know this verse really isn't in go with context with that, but Proverbs 22, verse 6, train up a child in the way he should go. When he's old, they won't depart from it. That's what we want to do. You've heard the verse preached many times. It can be preached two ways. Train up a child right. Lord willing, when they're old, they're going to come back to the ways that are right. You've heard it preached the other way as well. You train up a child in the wrong ways, you know what? That's how they're going to grow up too. Well, you know what? We're desiring here to train them right. We're desiring to be an outreach and share the gospel in a way that when we see these kids, when they're not 60 and 70 serving the Lord, we want to see these kids when they're 20. When they're 30. When they're 40. When they're in their age of service. We want to instill in them the truths of the Word of God. That's why these teachers are going to teach this week. That's why they've spent time and prepared and are ready for tomorrow. We're leaving a legacy, if you would. And what's neat is we're all part of that. That's for some reason I can't get over that. We're all part of that together. Members of Community Baptist Church, brothers and sisters in Christ, we're all part of that. We're all part of the next generation. And let me tell you something, it happened this morning. It just doesn't start tomorrow. It was going on this morning in our church. It was going on in Sunday school. It was going on in junior church. It was going on last month and the month before and the year before. And all these things work together for this common goal that we can share the gospel with these young people and that they will come to know Jesus Christ as their Savior. And boy, isn't it a blessing when they do, when we can share in that. Pray with me in that regard. Also, it gives the church a chance to serve. That's why we have Bible school. It's a great ministry opportunity for you and I to serve. To serve our young people, to serve our community, and then to come together and to serve together And I want to tell you, folks, you do this well. You come together well. Things are done quickly. Things are done just efficiently and just in with a mindset of doing it right. And man, you guys work together well. And I pray that you would pray this week for us as we work together this week, that we would see that unity this week as teachers and helpers. And we have a great team. I didn't count my list, but man, we have a great team. What's neat about that team is every year we use the teenagers as part of this ministry. Each teenager will have a job to do this week. So buckle up. You're not slacking off. There's a job for you to do. You know, I want to see that. I want to see our young people serve. I want to see our teens serve. They're going to be in classrooms helping with Bible verses. They're going to be at game time running around. They're going to be helping Mrs. Taylor carry cookies and juice and helping during craft. And boy, it's a great service opportunity for all of us, including our young people, to get them involved in a local church ministry so that, you know what, they'll be burned in as well. We also have it because it builds relationships with our kids and our parents. It's a great ministry to build relationships. I can't tell you how many times that just over the years, you know, you see the little ones come, and after time, you know what happens? You see mom and dad come to something like Community Day. Or you see mom and dad come to a wild game dinner, or our, I left this off the list and I shouldn't have, our bus Christmas dinner. These are all ministries where we are desiring to build relationships with these kids and parents. We are loving these kids, really, to, because we ought to. We're going to get to that in a second. But we want to let mom and dad know we love their kids. We're not just babysitting them. We're not just here filling a spot just because, you know, they sent them here. We love them. We want mom and dad to know that. We want mom and dad to know that we love them too, and that we care about them, and we're investing in the lives of their young people. We also have Bible school because it creates lasting memories. All of you that have been part of a Bible school, I'm sure we could go around the room tonight and give some illustrations of times when you were in Bible school. Some things you remember all those years ago. Isn't it something how those memories stick with you your whole life? And you might not, you know, you might not know who your teachers were or what the lessons were, but, you know, you have some distinct memories about Bible school. To this day, I remember the penny weigh-in thing. I mean, as a kid, we robbed our parents blind to find pennies, you know? We wanted the boys to win. Now we encourage you here, young people, to work for your pennies. Don't rob your mom and dad. Go to mom and dad, say, is there a chore we can do to earn some money for Bible school? All right? We have bricks here that we started doing a few years back. We painted some bricks gold, and praise the Lord, there has not been one toe broken as of yet. Mr. Doro, knock on some wood here, right? We don't sell them, but, you know, $5, if they give $5, they get a gold brick, they get to bring it down front here. I just remember the penny weigh-in when I was a kid. I've told you before, I remember Mopsy and Derby. Big dog, I think it was a dog, wife and husband dress up like a big dog and clown, chase each other around the church, act like just a bunch of crazies. To this day, I remember Mopsy and Derby. And I'm not crazy because Ms. Forrester can tell you who they are too. Right? I'm probably showing my age when I start talking about Mopsy and Derby, but that's just a great, that's what they did. They traveled around and did Bible schools. Or it was Mrs. Forrester and I didn't know it. Maybe it very well could have been. Just some great memories. You know what I do remember too? I don't know why this was, but I do remember going over. I had a friend across the street who's a little bit older than me. His name was Sean. But I remember inviting Sean to church for Bible school. I couldn't tell you today if I ever invited him to church for junior church or Sunday school. But I know I invited him to Bible school. I wanted more pennies. Those are memories, right? And now listen, I, those aren't terribly spiritual memories, but those are things that I still have to this day. that stick with me. Now, we are desiring to create lasting memories. Turn with me to Deuteronomy. Chapter 6. We'll be done in just a minute. Deuteronomy chapter 6. Look at verse 4, if you would. Deuteronomy 6, 4 says, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thine heart, and with all thine soul, with all thy might. These words which I command thee this day shall be in thine heart." Look at verse 7. This is why we have it. Remember, we said we're trying to create lasting memories. Verse 7, "And thou shalt teach them." What are we teaching? The words of the Lord. "We shall teach them diligently unto thy children, and shalt talk of them when thou sittest in thine house, and when thou walkest in the way, and when thou liest down, and when thou risest up. And thou shalt bind them for a sign upon thine hand, and they shall be as frontlets between thy eyes. Thou shalt write them upon the post of thy house and on thy gates." Look at that. I know this principle is about how to have a godly home and how to train your young people as a parent, but this is what we're going to do at church. This is what we desire to do at church. We're going to have the word of God on our lips, and you're going to hear it come out of our mouths. And if we could, we'd write it on their foreheads and on the back of their hand, wherever we could, for them to remind them of the truths of God's word. But we want this week to be a time of lasting memories. Not only just in my case, apparently I wasn't a very spiritual kid, where all I remember is Pennies and Mobsy and Derby, but I would like some of these kids, you know what, to come away knowing some of these Bible verses, and I'm sure I did. But that's what we're doing. These kids throughout this week, they're going to be encouraged to memorize the most verses in their class. And some of them are really going to diligently work for this. They're going to commit this word of God to their heart and to their memory. And they're going to get these things down. That's what we desire. As we said through this list tonight, we want to see them saved. And then, man, we want to see the word of God in their heart. We want to see the word of God in their mind, so they, when they come across a situation in life, whether it be being that they're a young person 5 years from now, or 10 years from now, or 20 years from now, some of these truths they learned at Giddyup Junction through God's word would be in their mind, would be in their heart. And boy, wouldn't it be something? Then if one day, get this now, they're doing what Deuteronomy is telling us to do to their family. They're passing it on to their children. It's on their voice. They're writing it on the walls of their house and on their gates. Think of that. Folks, you don't know where next week will end, because it really doesn't. God's word doesn't return void. We don't know how far outreaching these ministries really go. We will when we get to heaven. We'll see the benefit of all those things that day. But here on earth, we just rest assured that God is doing a work, and he's using these ministries for his perfect will and purpose. Think about that tonight. You have a burden for Bible school? You have a burden for our young people? And lastly tonight, why have Bible school? It's an opportunity to love. And not just love these children and love their family, but it's an opportunity to show the love of Christ to these young people this week who, hear me now, some may not be in a very loving environment. Some may not be raised up like some of you and I were. Amen. And we're going to show them what love is. But we're going to show them what the love of Christ is. And that as much as we love them and we want to minister to them, we're going to tell them there's someone that loves them even more. You have a burden for Bible school? We're going to tell them that someone loved them so much, he died for them, for their sin. That's what we're going to do in Bible school. And boy, what a legacy to leave. Not knowing what will take place, not only this week, looking for God to do great things, but in the weeks ahead and the months ahead and the years ahead, what this week's Bible school will do in the lives and the families of these young people in the community around us. As we close, as I said, we all have stories about a Bible school maybe we were part of as a young person, and maybe you didn't. That's okay. I'll tell you right now, when I was thinking about Penny's, I never in a million years thought I'd be preaching Bible school or teaching Bible school. You don't know. You don't know how God is going to use these things. What I want you to get tonight, hear me now. You're all part of that. You're all an active part in this special ministry that we call Bible school. You have a burden for it tonight? I hope you leave with one. Spend some time this week. You think about us, think about these teachers, pray for them. It's going to be some hot days. Be some warm weather. That's okay. You think about us, think about these teachers, think about these young people. Get a vision for them, their families. Get a burden for what we're going to do here this week. I'm going to do something that we normally don't do. This is a little out of ordinary. I'm going to take a little bit of liberty here tonight. But before we close, I would like to commit this week to the Lord. I would like you to do the same. I'm going to have a couple of you men pray. And as they pray, my hope is that you'd pray with us. It's great to use words like we're going to see God work in miraculous ways and we're going to have a fantastic week. That's fine. Those are wonderful things. I want God to move how God wants to move. I want to see God work in a way this week where you can't deny it was of God. I don't want you to think it was because Mr. Doro is such a great song leader, or how handsome he is leading those songs. Love you, brother. I want you to know God did something special. I hope you pray with us tonight. Mr. Doro, I'm going to have you pray. Phil Cates, I'd like to have you pray. And then Tim, would you be ready to lead our invitation after Mr. Cates gets done praying, and we'll have our first invitation after that. Folks, I do pray that you join us tonight. Commit yourselves that you're going to spend time this week with a burden about what's going to go on here. Commit with us to pray for these young people and their salvation, for their spiritual growth. Commit with us that we pray that as a church body, we'd grow even closer together here at Community Baptist Church. What a great opportunity to serve the Lord together. Mr. Doro, would you lead us, please?
Have Vacation Bible School. here at Community Baptist Church. Lord, thank you for the building that we have. Thank you for the grounds that we have. Thank you for the message that we have, that you've given us through your word. And Lord, I would just pray that this week you would use your word in a mighty way. Through the workers, to the kids that are there, to their parents. Lord, I pray that you would work on hearts, that there would be unity throughout our church, and that everything that we do would be to glorify your name.
Yes.
Lord, I pray that you would prepare young hearts, Lord, that need to know you as their personal Savior. Maybe need an understanding. Maybe they have a realization of God, but they don't understand about salvation. I just pray, Lord, that you would open that up to them, that the gospel would be clear this week. Lord, maybe there are hearts that know, but Lord, they haven't accepted you yet. And Lord, I pray that you would work on them too. Lord, there may be some that have never even heard the good news of salvation.
Yes.
Lord, what a blessing that we have, that in everything that we do, we can present that good news. And I just pray, Lord, that you would help us to know what the need is. Lord, maybe there are kids or even adults, even the workers, Lord, that are saved, but we need to grow.
Yes.
I pray that we would grow together, Lord. I pray that the kids would grow in their knowledge and their understanding. Lord, that they would gain wisdom through this week and what you have in your word. And Lord, again, I thank you that we even have this opportunity. So many things in this world that would just pull in every other direction. Lord, we have the truth. We have your word. Help us, Lord, to be clear with it. Help us, Lord, to be loving, to be kind, to be gentle, Lord, when we need to be gentle. Be firm when we need to be firm. Lord, help us to just be Christ-like in everything that we do. We pray this in your precious name.
Heavenly Father, we are a needy people. We need your help. We love you. We know that we can do nothing without your strength. And we pray that as a church family that we would have your grace and your love to show to each and every one of these that come for Vacation Bible School. We pray for power and strength for your message.
Yes.
That your spirit would work in the hearts and lives of young people as they come, and that we might see them saved, but also that we would see the parents saved because of the work that you're doing through this church and through the people that we have. We pray for the hands that will be working this week, that you would just guide them, give them discernment, help them, Lord, to have the burden and the sense of urgency that everyone that is lost is headed to hell without a Savior. And we pray, Father, that we would have that passion, that we would have that urgency to share the gospel with those that we come into contact with, especially this week with Bible school. And we pray that you go before us, that you would work in those hearts, and that you would prepare these young people. And also, Lord, prepare us as workers that we might be able to do the work that you have called us to do, that we must do this, because you have commanded it, Lord, more so because you loved us so much that we want to try and provide an opportunity to worship you that you might be glorified. We pray for every facet of this service throughout the week. We pray for the music. We pray for the games. We pray for the teachers as they teach. We pray for craft time. We pray for every part of this, that you would be in control, that your hand would be guiding every part of it. Father, thank you for the leadership of this church and for those that have prepared We look forward to a great time. We know that our prayers, Lord, are going to you. And we just ask that you would answer these prayers. This is an urgent need that we have, that we would see young people saved tonight. So, Father, as we think about what's coming up, we know you will work. We have faith that you will be faithful to us as much or more so than we could ever be faithful to you. And so we just ask, Father, that you would bless this week, bless each and every person that's involved. Again, that you would get the glory and honor that you so deserve. We pray for safety as people travel. We know that some will come from a distance, but we also know that boys and girls will be coming, and they may not have transportation, so we pray for them that they would find a ride, that they would invite their friends, that they would have that urgency, that they would tell their friends as well. So, Father, we just pray again that you would bless this week. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.